I walk tall. And though it took me a while, I'm ready now. I love you all. Luna. Guys. Dad. The time we had together, I cherish. Kings of Lucis. Come to me!
This is just painful, man. Okay, unlike the nuke went off. I think we're good to go. What the fuck? I don't even know what's happening. This is the I know he's gonna purge it, but it's like some weird shit. Like, you just warp through a fucking portal. Yeah, this game is crazy. This game does weird shit. I expect a quick time event here. Oh, man. Nice. It's literally left nothing of him. Yeah, but he has to give his life now, doesn't he? That's rough, man. It's not a sweet ending for this game.
It's finally over.
There's no happy ending for this one.
Fairy tale beginning, huh, Prince Noctis?
We let ourselves get carried away.
Look, these things happen.
Let's just hope this isn't some omen.
Gladio, do me a favor.
What?
Push this thing by yourself.
All by myself?
You won't even notice if we just let go.
Prompto, don't even think about it.
Save some breath for pushing.
Ignis, come on, time to switch.
Nah, we just switched back there.
Yeah, that's the photo. I wonder if they have different outros for various, like, story-related photos. So, basically, yeah, that's it for Final Fantasy XV. I don't know, man. Like, I feel like the first half of this game is really, really fun and really, really good. And just the second linear half is just, like, boring. It's just not well done at all, I feel. Matt Mercer, Corleonis, see that? I peeped that at the last second. But yeah, I don't think that this game really... It feels like this game was two different games at some point that got smashed together. And that's kind of what ended up happening. And I don't really understand why they did that or what made them want to pursue that. But it ends up making this game just feel horribly weird and out of place. You know, you have this first half, which is this vast open world environment, you know, where you explore and do a whole bunch of stuff. And then I'm gonna have to take this song out for copyright anyway, so unfortunately it's gonna get muted. And the second one is, you know, the second half is linear, easy, you know, unlike Final Fantasy XIII, which was hard linear, this game is easy linear. So it's just like, okay, like even if you were the appropriate level, like there's only a few enemies that you realistically can't do at like level 40. So, this game starts out completely differently than it finishes, but not in a way that's really good. I feel like half the time, so let's talk about the open world, right? The good news is that the open world is open world, and it's really great and it's really cool. This game starts out like a road trip, you're exploring a world, you're going to do this, that, and the other, whatever. The game takes a turn for the dark, right? And then after that, the game stays open world, but things change, you get more powerful, you can go to new areas, you can accept new quests, you can do hunts, you can do this, you can do that. And while it is true that the only real city that they build up is Lestalem, and then there's all these little outposts, so it makes you wonder where all the population even lives, you have this big city of Lestalem that you barely even explore any of it. It's just a real quick tidbit, you never really do much in it. Like, this game dumps the good open world building that it started with too quickly, I feel, for just tedium and repetitive quests. And that's the one problem with the beginning of the game, but that's forgivable, because I can understand this is an RPG, this is, you know, something they've never done before. It's forgivable and it's fun. Oh, this would have been a better photo, honestly. I kind of fucked up on that. But yeah, it would be forgivable if it was, you know, a little more than just what it ended up being. That game that I played for the first whatever hours up until last night, that game was great. That game, Final Fantasy XV, like, part one, is like an 8 out of 10, an 8.5 out of 10, you know? It has problems, the camera in combat spinning around, the foliage and the tight environment, same problem as Zestiria, you can't see what the fuck's going on, you don't know when to block or when to attack. You have the lock-on that randomly switches targets and doesn't really persist if you do any, like, you know, cinematic moves or whatever. You've got, okay, there's a lot of funny stuff in the story, a lighthearted whatever, but that's forgivable. You know, you got a lot of stuff going on that's weird and awkward and stuff like that. But it's okay. It's still a fun experience, still a good game. The second half is super linear. The only thing that it really has going for it is the deeper story, but it feels weird because you didn't really build up to it. It feels like it's just rushed. It feels like they just had half a game, and then they had to, or a third of a game, and they had to cut it off and develop, you know, 8 chapters to conclude the game with that are rushed as hell. So, I just feel like this game was in development for too long.
The four of us around a campfire. How long's it been? An eternity. So, yeah.
Coleman plug. They don't know he has to die, do they?
Out with it.
I just... so hard. So I've made my peace. Still, knowing this is it, and seeing you here now, it's more than I can take. Yeah, you're damn right it is.
Huh, you spit it out. It's good to hear.
Well? What can I say? Do you guys... are the best?
Okay, nice. That was incredibly loud. But yeah, no, that's what I'm saying. Like, the first half of the game feels like they had an idea for what they wanted to do. They wanted to try something that they had never done before, and it's really fun and interesting. So that part of the game is like an 8.5. It's like great, it's fun, it's interesting, it's different. And it has flaws, you know, the camera spinning like it's stuck on a fucking rotor, and the foliage, the dropping in tight boxes or whatever, the annoying dungeons with no explanation. But all that is forgivable because the experience and the fun of it is still there. It's still good to play and it's still interesting to play. Interesting to level up, interesting to do stuff. Great, that's fine. That's like average, above average RPG-ness right there. Whatever, and there's some little feeble shit like, you know, oh, I can't hit the right button. Oh, I'm standing over an item. I hit X, I don't pick up the item. Or I'm trying to talk to someone, I end up jumping in their face 3 times because it doesn't read it. Whatever. Little nuisances on the road. What really hurts this game is the gameplay and the story. The story of this game just does not seem to really mesh well or just about with its own self. So on the first half, it's very slow-paced. very, okay, we're going to find these Armiger items, we're going to grab them, we're going to travel around on like a road trip, kind of, and then we're going to, you know, do all this stuff, then we're going to come home and take it back. That all changes. You know, they never really develop a single plot line in this game, and I think that's the problem. The first part of the story, they develop this plot line of, we need to stop the Empire. The second half of it is like, okay, we need to get rid of the Star Scourge. And while both are mentioned, you know, in the first half and the second half, neither of them are really developed, I feel. Neither of them really go anywhere ridiculous. They don't get developed as full ideas. And that's just kind of what ends up being the death of this story, is that it has to switch between multiple plot lines that never get really progressed. So that is unfortunately the fall point of this story. I'm sorry. It was okay to start, but then they threw everything that they did in the first half away in chapter 8 to start something new that they didn't fully develop because they rushed it. It was too short. It's sad. It really is. I'm disappointed. I'm not amused. Like, what could have been above average is yeah. It just ends up being, it has identity crisis, I want to say. The game doesn't know what it wants to be the most, so it ends up being a little bit of everything, which is good, and a little bit of everything, which is bad. So, 10 years, man. I don't think this game was worth 10 years. So, it is good that you can see all these areas in the morning. That is a nice snapshot right there.
Dearest Luna.
What it would have been like if everything wasn't all fucked up. Well, that was the time the car broke down. It would have been real sweet, but... Yep, that's where we get the logo from. Alright, well, that's interesting, but it's sad, man. It really is. Yep, they put him there too, that's cool. I always love that artwork, because it reminds me of old school Final Fantasy. I don't know. And didn't they say that they didn't want to have multiple sequels to this game, so they were going to make the game as long as, like, three Final Fantasy games or something? They were going to have a complete outro, you know? Whatever. Congratulations on completing the game. To view your certificate of completion from the archives and share your... Okay, whatever. Just, everyone knew I was going to beat this game. Level 68. That's the picture. Very good. This is the entire reel of my photos. Every photo I took. Yeah, see, I didn't really get any from these last couple of chapters, but... Oh, well. I mean, yeah, I mean, that's honestly what I think about this game. I feel like this game feels like two separate games that got congealed into one, and that really ultimately hurts the game as we scroll through the photos here, just, you know, for one last time. It's just that this game tries to be one thing at the start, it changes to another thing, and then it changes immediately to three different things throughout the story. So the whole plot with the Armagers gets dropped. The whole road trip gets dropped. Everything that really gets built up in the first half of the game, all right, we're going to strike back against the Empire. They never really go much in depth about the Empire. You know, they don't really give much story about it. And I mean, again, I really stress this. Look at other Final Fantasy games. You know, look at 12. Look at 4, you know, where there's this Empire that's fighting. Look at 2, you know, and they really build up stuff about it through other characters, through dialogue, through all sorts of stuff. This game does not do that. This game just says, oh, there's an empire, they're taking over everything, they've basically taken over everything. Okay, they kill the king's dead, you have to now come over and destroy the empire. And I mean, this whole plotline with the Star Scourge can be involved. You know, there's other games that do multiple plotlines like this, but this game doesn't do that. This game basically destroys what it builds up in the first half for the second half. And I think that that's, like, I don't get it, you know? And the road trip idea itself is like, once you hit clean, that's it. That's basically the end of the deal. So really, Episode Dusk is about a third of the game, you know, just minus story, you know, context, and minus, you know, random quests and whatnot. Episode Dusk, if you get to it, that's it. You basically played a third of the game. You played the one with the shitty battle music, I think. Or, okay, let me not call it shitty. The one I don't like. Fine. Fair enough. But like, that's it, you know, like, so I basically played a third of the game a year ago. The only thing left was, like, okay, more side quests, a little bit more refined stuff, and that's it, you know? I feel a little disappointed that this game has, I basically reached the end of the open world segment in, like, 10 hours. Like, that was it. There was nothing else to do. I feel incredibly let down that that's all that there really is, and then the remainder of the game is linear. I don't give much credit for the linear stuff, and the reason why is because linear stuff can be done by anyone now. Like, there are indie games that are linear like what this game does, and they do more. You know, like, that second half of the game, the only good thing it has going for it is the depth of the plot. If it does... But yeah, no, just the pacing, I mean, again, the biggest thing I think I'll say is just that the pacing and the flow of this game is way off. It's like they really didn't know what they wanted to do more. So I think that's one of the biggest problems with it, is just that this game doesn't know if it wants to be linear or if it wants to be free roam, and then what is there in those equal segments is not done well much at all. You know, we got complexity and depth for the second half, but it never really develops. They just kind of throw stuff at, you know, the characters. They make Ignis blind, Prompto goes missing. It's the same problem with Watch Dogs 2. You know, not to, you know, say anything about the plot of that game, but it's like literally just finished that game a day before I played this game, and it's the same problem. These games both have the same problem. The game doesn't know what it wants to be story-wise, if it wants to be a lighthearted, typical journey, or if it wants to be a super serious, dark, gritty Final Fantasy, which it does succeed at the end, but I don't know. This was a good one. I remember that one. This was also another stellar photo. You tell me what's going on. It looks like it's fighting a behemoth or something. I have no clue. I remember specifically taking that one because of that. This was another good one. Yeah, this one will hurt your eyes at night. So, this game is still overall a good game. I do want to emphasize that. It's still overall a good game, but it could be better in almost every aspect, and the storytelling has been done better in almost every Final Fantasy before it. You know, at least Final Fantasy X, for its simplistic story, had the flow right. It had the right amount of everything. I didn't like Final Fantasy X's story. I think it's too much of a love story. It's not serious enough where it counts, but it's still a cohesive story. Like, the story starts at quality of whatever. The quality doesn't change. The quality stays the same. This game has that problem. And it sucks, man, because you know what? I waited 10 damn years for this game, and I wanted it. I don't know. I wanted it to be better than this. I took it for granted it was going to be better than this. I want to keep saying it's a good game. This is one of the best photos. This is an amazing photo. So, fair enough in that regard. But I just feel like the second half of the game, like, takes no clues, no nothing from the first half. You know? This entire game almost feels like, I don't know if this game started out as an entirely linear game and then they just cut out the front half, or if this game started out as entirely free roam, open world style like the last games. I can't tell, because this game splits itself down the middle so much, it's impossible. I do feel like this game started as a open world free roam game. But I feel like at some point they were like, shit, we don't know if we want to commit to this, so we'll do this instead. I don't know. I will say this, Lightning Returns is better than this game. And the reason why I'll say that is, even if the remainder of the 13 trilogy sucks ass, right? I'm going to just throw them under the bus. I'm not even gonna argue that they're good games. Lightning Returns has a more cohesive, better story. Lot more free roam, lot more open-endedness. The open world of Lightning Returns is better than this game. Is better overall because of the way they handle it. And I'm not saying because, oh, there's less stuff to do in it. I think I said this in the playthrough. There's less stuff to do in the open world of Lightning Returns, but at least that game lends itself naturally to exploration. Okay, I come here at 10 a.m., there's a dude that needs a quest. I come back at 9 p.m., there's another person that needs a quest. Or maybe there's a quest here that I need to complete. You know, like, there's mobs I need to fight. There's a reason to explore that game and to play it over and over again. The problem with that game was the difficulty jump at the end was stupid. But that game, I think, is better than this game overall. This game had 10 years of development. Lightning Returns had like 2, maybe 3, if they got a jump start on it. And I just feel like it's a shame. It is a damn shame that this game could not have been better. That it chooses to be what it is. Well, it didn't choose it. It was developed. But you know what I mean. That this is basically what they concede to. That's disappointing, man. I'm disappointed. Yeah, what the fuck is even going on in this picture? It looks like he's floating. He probably is floating. So, anyway. This is another good one, but anyway. Save completion data. Okay, you can also return to... Yes, okay. So we will save over World of Ruin. The Cure for Insomnia. So whenever New Game Plus comes, I'll check it out. You know me. Sure, whatever. I don't know. Like, all the different ways you can go around and figure stuff out and stuff, it just feels like this is two completely separate games. I'm playing basically... What the fuck? Okay, whatever. Oh, look, they block the change in the title screen. That's pretty cool. Alright, load the save game. They block it. They don't want people to know that that's the truth of it. Chapter 15, End of the Road. Call Umbra and tour the world at your leisure. You might even find some new treasures buried under your nose. I feel like I'm playing, right, Final Fantasy versus 13 for the first half, and then Final Fantasy 15 for the second half. I feel that's what I'm doing. I hope they don't do this for Final Fantasy 16. This game, I have to keep saying this, this game is still a good game. But the problem is that this game is not good where it counts, and most of what it has been done better before. And that's not good enough, in my opinion. And my stupid headset, I gotta buy a new fucking headset. It's driving me nuts. I get it. There's no noise. There's gonna be noise in 5 seconds. They're gonna shut the fuck off. I hate it. I hate it. I hate this headset. But it's the only one I could afford. I hate this headset. I honestly do. Yes. Okay. So how do we get out of here? You might not be able to once you get in here. Yeah, no. I think this is the subway. You're stuck here now. Yeah, so, I mean, whatever. I'll just return to the past. I mean, there's not really much to do in the past, but I'll just get out of here because there's no reason to go here. Or there's no reason to stay here. I just feel like there's so many plot lines that they left empty. Like, the Emperor's motivations are explained after you beat him. Like, there's no lead-up to it. It's just, oh, I wanted to rule the world or divine right, blah, blah, blah. Want to expand, whatever. Like, all these other characters, like, Final Fantasy VI, right? Emperor Gestal's desires, you are explained in the story. All this stuff is explained, you get it in the story, and that game also has a big shift halfway, right? But it's handled better because they built up the first half much better than this game does, and it's more or less uniquely the same stuff. This game abandons what it starts with. So again, Versus 13, great game, or whatever the first half, whatever you want to call it. Final Fantasy 15, linear, of average. It's an average game. So, usually by the end of these JRPG playthroughs, I'm super happy, excited, whatever. This time, I'm not. I'm just depressed. Because this is a game that was in development for 10 years, you know? There are games in development for 2 years that come out better than this. I don't know what to tell you, you know? There's games that are in development for a fifth of the time that are twice as good. With the same amount of content. Right? I spent 20 hours in Chapter 8 just doing side quests. And yeah, they were menial side quests, whatever. But that's still more the time than I spent playing through the end of the game. The end of the game is like maybe 5-6 hours after that. What RPG do you know where you beat the game at like level 40? Like, that's real low. But I mean, not only that level, but like, what RPG do you know you beat the entire second half of the game in 6 hours? That's a 12-hour. If you rush this game, basically this game.
Hold up, pretty sure if we
can. Oh look, I'm into unknown frontiers.
They form some kind of part.
Let's not speculate. Let's ask an expert.
Yeah, Cindy.
Let's just hope old Sid doesn't feel too left out.
Okay. Anyway. Yeah, my stats decreased for some reason. Oh, because my gear changed. That's why. Okay, I'm an idiot. Sorry. Forgot. Whoops. What is this? Allows the king to move freely and recover health faster. Okay, yeah. That's why. Okay, I'm an idiot. I can't believe I forgot. That's why. Ultima. What was it? No, okay. Can we clear this? Put on the ring, which gets its own slot. Probably going to add more of them, I guess. So there is a tomb somewhere out here that I did not get, which is fine because I don't particularly care enough. Wait, what does Gladio have? Oh, he has Hyperion. Okay, that's good. So I can have that. Let's put on. Let me get the right slots. Right, put on Thunderbolt. Put on. What was it? The Sword of the Father? It's actually pretty weak. It makes the Great greater. So what does it even do? It increases strength by 100 and magic by 100 and defense. So is that even worth it? health by 100. Yeah, I think this isn't that bad. Yeah, right? Blade of the Mystic seems better. This is way, but you lower your elemental resistances nonstop. Lower your ballistic resistances, but... Let's see. This doesn't seem to have any downsides. Just increases MP. I'm just gonna put on the Sword of the Wise. I'm sure if you wield nothing but Arminger weapons, you do even better. Now, why do I have more HP than Gladio? Okay, I don't know. I guess that's just it. Because of his gear change too. Kingsglaive garb. Yeah, here we go. What the hell? I like how the less armor he puts on, the bigger his stat bonus is. Okay. Invigorates the wearer's spirit. What the hell? Take this shit off. It's not really good. What about Prompto? It looks nice, but it doesn't benefit them. Like, they need health. There you go, and more damage. So, forget it. Whoops. There you go. That's why costumes are typically not used for stats. But yeah, that's basically it. So I have 21,000. I mean, there's no real reason to bank it. Is Taka's quest available?
No.
Doesn't seem like it.
So what'll it be today?
People sprint without expending stamina. Increasing maximum. That's expensive, man. So basically now, this is free roam mode. You can explore what little open world this game has now. And, yeah. I mean, well, not little in the sense that there's not a lot, but I mean that the sense that that's basically it. This is the same open world you were dumped in Chapter 3. That's it. Nothing has really changed, so. Disappointing, to say the least. I'm really just saddened, unfortunately, but... That's going to be it for the playthrough. I'm sure there's going to be other stuff added later on. I already know there's more stuff to do, but I'm going to stop here. It's not, man. It's sad. It's sad I waited 10 years to play this game. So excited. And really got no payoff at the end. I really just feel that's beyond sad. Because what is here is good, right? But instead of mixing it all together into perfection... They keep it separate, they bake it separate, and it ends up feeling just two different flavors that don't really congeal together. So, I'm disappointed, but that's going to be it. Now, if there's DLC, I know the New Game Plus stuff is coming out later and whatnot, so that might be something that I do later as I play that, but until then, Spring Point 1000, worth picking up if you like RPGs, but... Don't think it really lives up to the hype, at least I don't think it does. So, I'll see you guys whenever.